Quasars to Sea Stars is a 3 or 4 year work study program where you get to pursue your passion in science and see new opportunities in the scientific community.
Like in the summer, during your first year, you have Museum 101. You go around to different departments in the museum and like learn how it all works. You go to collections and research, exhibits, education, development, places like that. And you also do camps, which is really fun. You get to learn some leadership skills and like what goes on behind the camps.
There's even times during like the actual school year itself where you have to, you get to actually come to the museum and work. It really depends on where you go. You could be working in like places like invertebrate zoology where you get to learn about living creatures, or you could be working in places like exhibit which require a lot of manual work.
You start to take classes. The classes that you take are based on our topic that year. So this year it's endangered species. And so you have a class once a week and you take a field trip.
The quasar trips are really fun because it gives you a chance to bond with all the quasars, and we learn really in depth. We have people there with us who are really knowledgeable. So it's a lot of learning, it's a lot of hands-on stuff, a lot of bonding, and it's really fun.
The experience of going with people who are the same age as you, that are also interested in the things that you're interested in, is really unique. They're definitely once-in-a-lifetime opportunities that you get to have.
You also have access to locations that the public might not actually have access to, and you get to learn from real scientists who are pursuing their passions in science. We went to the Bitter Creek National Wildlife Refuge.
And we saw a lot of condors. It was really cool. Some of them flew over our campsite. It's where they check up on them, make sure they're doing okay, and send them back into the wild. So that was really cool to see. They're carrion eaters, so they eat dead animals.
Yeah, and that's why they don't have any like hair on their heads too, so like if they like get their head like in a carcass, they're not getting like rotting flesh stuck in their feathers.
We had a great experience with some field biologists there.
Joseph was the main condor guy. He was the one in the film about condor 599, and we got to see a workup on that condor, just making sure the condor was healthy. So there was a pen where they took turns like capturing one condor. They finally caught the condor that they were gonna do the workup on. And once the condor was in the net, they had to put their hand on its head because the beak is the most dangerous part of the bird.
They use their heads to like get in there on like prey. So like it's gonna be like a sharp beak. You had to do it kind of slow because they're faster than you.
And if you do it slow, like they don't really notice it.
Yeah, they don't see it as a threat.
We took the condor's blood sampling and we analyzed their feathers to see if they were healthy.
They also changed the tracking number if it was dirty. And they also cleaned off their feet.
Well, they cleaned off their feet so they could take their blood and not get it infected.
Condors actually pee on their legs to cool themselves down, which was really, really interesting.
We got to look at them up close. We got to see them being tagged, checked up. It was a very like unique, once-in-a-lifetime experience, in my opinion. Just seeing them just like going from being in a cage to going to fly away out in the open, it was a really beautiful sight, in my opinion.
So after lunch, we talked to the Young Birders group, and they showed us how they took their field notes. They had these really good illustrations of the birds and insects and other things that they saw.
Later that afternoon, we went up to a place called Hilltop, where we were able to learn about how the field biologists use radio telemetry to track the condors, and that was a really cool experience.
She had like a metal rod that had like other rods like coming from it, and then she pointed it different directions and she marked the beeps, and the beeps represented the condors. And they were doing like if this condor is over there.
And also if they, at the time, if they were like flying or resting, they have like the largest wingspan in North America, and it's 9 feet, which is really large. It was like a lot of open space and a lot of wildlife. The stars were really cool.
it's something about the trips that allow you to get a lot closer with the people that you're around. It's just something that like pulls all of us together so close that we forget that we were strangers like the day before.
That was our fifth trip, and we have one more trip planned for this summer too.
When you get to be a senior, you tend to focus in more on one area of the museum that you are most interested in.
For me, I'm focusing a lot more in education, scientific education, so I've been working in school and teacher services to create a curriculum on geology. I'm planning on attending a four-year university. Quasars has helped me narrow down what I want to pursue in science.
Honestly, right now, I'm not too sure about what my career will be, but I know definitely something science-oriented. I think Quasars will definitely help me figure that out because it's helping me explore different topics in science. And I'm just having a lot of fun in Quasars in the science part, and I would want to do that for the rest of my life, so.
You really have to be willing to take the time and work at the museum. It takes a lot of commitment. You have to sacrifice sports, you have to sacrifice alone time, but I definitely feel that in the end, it's all definitely worth it. You get to learn amazing new things, make great new friends, while at the same time, just being able to be in a place where you really enjoy yourself.
Quasars is a big commitment, but it's definitely one that you will not regret making because you get to do so many things that are so unique and different from what everybody else is doing, and you get to have the experience of a lifetime, really, in high school, and you're just, doors open up to you that would not open up in any other circumstances.
I second that, for sure. I don't know if I could have said it any better, so.